Good evening. My name's Sean Burke, I'm the Associate Athletic Director here. Thank you for coming. And before we get started this evening, truly, genuinely, I want to thank every single one of you for the respect that you showed coming into the gym this evening, just by saying thank you to our students and staff that were handing out the information to you. That says a lot about you all, so thank you for being so respectful and polite. We have a great program this evening. I would like to first thank the Student Affairs Office, particularly Adrian Frame, Brianna McCann, Scott Russell, and Phil Rowe for being here this evening and putting this program on in conjunction with the Department of Athletics. I would also like to thank the coaches that are here on supporting this program as well. Gentlemen, that I'm going to introduce you to, to just say a few words before we get going with the program this evening. Our Director of Athletics, Dr. Brian Wiley. Brian has been the catalyst, the person with the insight, the guider of this entire department over a number of years. He is our leader who has led the department in his short time as being the Director of Athletics, the 37 conference championships, 39 NCAA tournament appearances, 10 CAC championships, a ranking of number 29 out of 444 Division III institutions in Clearfield Athletic Director standing. He has really had the foresight to lead us on and off the field, and this is another way that he has led us as student athletes to get to where we need to be as great individuals, great student athletes, and great people. So, Brian Wiley.
Thank you, Coach Burke. I too want to thank each of you for being here tonight. We know it's a really busy time with papers, exams, obviously narrowing down on the regular season and the playoffs. All of our fall teams are doing extremely well, so I wish you all a lot of luck as the season continues and then the winter sports starting up. You know, what we talk about, what this program and Mr. Green have been talking about, it's about the effects of alcohol and drugs on a college campus. You know about it, our coaches talk to you about it, and it's not something that you just heard about here at college. The one thing you can really think about, it, the two things that can derail your success here at a college, academically, and obviously your decisions with drugs and alcohol. So we're delighted to have Mike Green here. He was, if some of you remember, he was here 2 years ago, and I remember being in those doors at the end of the event, and many of our student athletes came up saying that this was the best event that we've ever had. So not only is Mike Green going to talk about his experience as an athlete, as an educator, as a coach, but also as a recovering alcoholic. He continues to work extensively with many colleges and student athletes. He continues to work with professional teams. He had an opportunity himself to pursue a career in the NFL. So it's my pleasure to introduce and welcome Mike Green.
You know, I never got into speaking about alcohol and drugs because I've always thought that would be my occupation back in college. Not at all. I wanted to go into the NFL, which I did, but I couldn't cut. So then I went back, got a master's degree in adult physics at Western University. That's why I played Division II football as a co-captain. But also when I came out, I decided to go back and coach football. It's everything I did. Loved athletics, football, basketball, go to college, play, have a great time, and I finished up have had beer drinking 101. They should have had wine tasting. They should have had mixology. Most of you would never miss those courses right there. You would never cut that. And you know something? Because if you teach somebody the social skills of what drinking is, you have a better chance. So as I do this, I had a lot of people call and ask me to speak. And bottom line, as being an alcoholic, I can tell you, don't listen day at a time. Last year, I celebrated living day at a time. 37 years being sober, living a day at a time.
Great quarterback. does 60 days in a rehab. And you know something, he comes out, he's not supposed to drink. He hires a guy to be with him, so he's not drinking. And then all of a sudden, he's 17. He's out with his girlfriend. But I guess they get into an argument because he was drinking that day. He gets arrested. And he's probably going to lose everything simply again because the addiction gets you. In this room, I don't want the addiction to get anybody. I want you to be able to know what it is. Getting out of nothing much really can hurt you. And Alcoholics Anonymous, we have a little joke. I'm addicted to the 51st state of the union. It's steady being fucked up. You know, there are people like me, I'm like yours. I get on my knees every morning and ask God to keep me sober. If I thank him again at night time, I'm only one drink away from getting out of nothing. How many of you drink this week? One drink. If I look around the room, it's in me.
Got engaged by senior year. You
beautiful young lady. My friends took me out and played the game Power Hour. How many have heard of Power Hour? One shot of beer every minute for 60 straight minutes. I did 90 of them. Never so drunk in my life. Somewhere my fiance did not work out. Oh, shit. I forgot she went to her parents and looked at me for the first time. She looked at me and said, you can't eat my parents something like that. Go into bed when you're sleeping off. And the next day she went, do you know what you did last night? How many have had someone say, you know what you did last night? You were definitely a one-way problem. What did I do? 2 hours later, I'm sitting on the couch. You walk out in front of my parents, totally naked. No clothes on. Walk directly over to the TV, turn it on, and pee in front of the TV. I pee in front of the TV, naked in front of your parents. Are you sure it was me? Well, who else would it be? She goes, my dad, you don't remember. You had a blackout. I don't know the term blackout. You don't have any alcoholic who had a blackout. You had too much alcohol too fast. Usually it's the hard alcohol. She gave me the ring back. And she said, you'll never get a second chance to make a first impression. I said, but well, I don't do that on purpose. No. But you lost respect. You lost something called integrity. You didn't pay me to allow me to be responsible. And you know something? We'll never get a second chance to make a first impression. And she was right. You lose everything because of that. At that point in my life, I wasn't an alcoholic. But I sure drank a lot because I was depressed after that. And the big thing is, you catch a lot of people, especially in relationships. How many know someone's been involved in a relationship that's gotten hurt because of alcohol? I get those phone calls all the time. Someone hit somebody. Someone said the wrong thing. My wife and I last year just got here in Atlantic City. And I watched the TV and I said, we're down here. What's going on? We have a great football player. Professional. That gets on an elevator. They've had a couple drinks. And he's arguing with his fiance. And she gave him a smack on the side of the head. You know, if your girlfriend gives you a smack on the side of the head, walk away. You know something? Go do something else. You know, on the field, we take a lot harder blows than that. But he came back and he punched her and knocked her out. There's no way you do that. You can't hit somebody in a relationship. They both get arrested. And you know something which I was proud of? Both of them went through therapy together to work it out, to get rid of the violence, to talk about how to resolve everything. And the big thing is, they went on and got married. But they didn't give them a second chance in the pros. And they got it right away. And that's one of the biggest things. You won't get a second chance to make a first impression of us. Domestic violence is out of control so fast it's not done. You know, walk away. Nobody deserves to get hit. No matter what the problem is. Just that simple. I'm not going to tell you the relationship. It's really tough at different times. How many got a number right now? I ask you this. How many have had a one-way problem? How many have had? How many women have had a one-way problem? They're the best. Can you have any moments in dream? I'm in jail in the building. Rebecca, what happened? I had 15 kamikazes. Why 15? Wanted to see what drunk was like at least once in my college career. What if you all the women were drunk and hungry, go to a restaurant? Only restaurant opens a brand new chicken diner. And there's a guy who put chicken uniform on flag and back together. We jumped the guy and stole his chicken uniform. I put it on and rode my bicycle around the campus at 3 o'clock in the morning with a chicken uniform on. Should I go on to the PlayStation stand with a chicken uniform on? Tears coming down, he comes to this show like this. Greatest thing we've ever seen. I said, what's the fine? $80 by so much. Well, then that guy gave me back at the restaurant. We had to go back and get the uniform back and money back and bring her and the students up. Father stacking goes, hey, you went back to the term one night, let her go. 5 years later, you get a phone call. Do you remember me? Yes, the chicken before. It's not so funny, I'm out of Harvard. I'm studying to be an attorney. On the bottom of the bar exam, there's a question that says, have you ever been arrested or do you have a criminal record? Could that one night of my life cost everything 5 years later? Absolutely. I called the listener, she doesn't have a record. But it really makes me think it only takes one from me. And
was not voting on the hall, I disagree. What happened, we had an around the world court. Each room had a different type of extreme. How many rooms did we go to? 20. What happened in the last room? My teammates told me to stand up on the windowsill, pull my pants down, and hang my naked ass out the window. You're hanging your ass out the window, 8 stories up. What happened? I got my ass stuck in the window. Later, I called the fire company to get my ass out of the window. At 2 o'clock in the morning, the fire's got a great big spot under my hands. A guy's coming up on the block, the guy's in a black shirt, and I think this is great. They get me to the hospital, you know, the doctor started laughing. He said, have you ever seen that guy Grady speak? You're called a one-way problem. And she sits down and she goes, Grady, you think I'm an alcoholic? No, you're a one-way problem with a funny consequence. You know, bottom line, you'll come back from here 10 years from now, people still can talk about your ass hanging out the window. We love stories like that. But my mom, they called her from school. They want to put me in rehab. They said if you had a problem one night, you were an alcoholic. That's a myth. It's not true. I'll call your mom. And the mom says, thanks, Brady. Because now I know the difference between a one-night problem and being an alcoholic. I think that's a big. You know, I was going to a school last year and spoke. All these guys in the state are from a football team. Some of those guys all were really friends of mine. We have a guy down in Virginia that became a head football coach, and we have one of the toughest guys on the team, a linebacker. A lot of one-way problems. Got kicked out of school for a little bit. Called me up on the phone, spoke with him almost a whole year, every 13 nights. You know what he changed? He gave me drinking up. He came back this year, he's been one of the best linebackers going. He wasn't like the coach in USC. He was able to change because he realized he had a one-way problem and didn't want to cost him anything ever again. So if you're sitting here right now and you have a one-way problem, I believe change. What's the biggest one-way problem you can get? I'm going to ask one of my coaches. Or, tell them the biggest one-way problem they can get.
Biggest?
The biggest.
By all Fox disease.
All Fox disease. I give him a round of applause. That's very good. Mark played at Homer College. He's the offensive line coach here. And he said all functions is. They never forgot. I don't know what all functions is. You have no idea. You're drunk and horny. You get your arm around somebody, you're smiling. Your friends are going, oh, my God. You don't get the hint. You take the person home and you sleep with them. This is where you all want to say this. So the next thing, we'll look at them and go, oh, fuck. How many of some of that all want to say this? Let me clarify. Mark did not have all want to say this. Just tell him what it was. I'm speaking to the school of Philadelphia. And the head basketball coach, his name was John G. Hall of Famer, goes like this. Hey, Brady, what a great thing you just said. They're all relaxed. They're laughing. They're having a good time. He said, all coaches need even I laugh. Which it made me think the greatest basketball player I've ever seen in my lifetime. It's a man by the name of Magic Johnson. He's not an alcoholic. He's not a bad person. He was an outstanding student athlete for Michigan State and loved Saturday night. Get one night out, you run, hook up with somebody, and you pull the rules of same sex. You go your way, they go their way, and 15 years later, there's an HIV because it's having a problem one night. How many people never connect having a problem one night with terms like HIV, STDs, acquaintance rate, date rape, sexual assault, or pregnancies? And by the way, the programs of HIV, I'm going to go like this. Not me, it only happens to the population of homosexuality. Or not me, it only happens not one population heterosexual, 18 to 25 years of age, going out and getting drunk and hooking up. Friends don't let friends fear God. When you see your buddy hooking up, you don't go like this. Go ahead and go for it. You pull a side signal over here. Get their phone number. Call them tomorrow. Get your eyes checked. What's wrong with you? Say something to the person. You know, the women have the greatest place to say.
front of the entire group with it. Whenever I are talking to anyone. Then now you're in a night, just run with self-control, walk back with us. The young lady came up, she goes, "Been waiting all night to tell you my one night story. I sat here last year and I lay up. I was a non-drinker. But you know, at the end of the year, we had initiation night. But it shouldn't go on because it's called AIDS. And you know something? We didn't take standards. And I got drunk for the first time. And my teammates told me they would take care of me. They forgot about me because they got drunk. She goes, "They got way better. I've only had one drinking experience." And you're right, Green. It only takes one drunk. And I know I'm not an alcoholic. And I think you should tell every woman in the group. You go out with the group and you come back with the group. You take care of each other just the way. How many would agree? You know, my son graduated from Bookmark College 2 years ago. And if you're going to brag a little bit, now's the time. When he graduated, he was co-captain of the team. And he had one of the best offensive line coaches you would ever meet. And he's your head football coach standing right over here. How about we give him a nice round of applause?
Get drunk,
And our manager, we have a great guy that never heard of this like this. Don't be slow questions, no more. We're proud of everybody here. You know, sometimes this isn't just an individual. We're a family. Like Rini was saying, you know who out is that. You don't hurt somebody. You have respect when you go out. And they got wrong and get held up and forget about respect. How many would agree with that? Sometimes you forget about respect and get held up. How many would agree? And that's a big why sometimes I make one by getting held up. And then the other one.
Because it causes so many problems. What's the name of the class? I'm going to have a so-called shot. What do you have? It's called a trigger, a portal, a sipping, a fine tuning. You're supposed to pick it up, take a little sip, put it down, take an hour to enjoy it. Put it on that. I'm going to call it shot, shoot, square, or double shot. Kind of like this one came out, just smile at it. You find yourself going, oh shit, here we go, here we go. I might have done a little bit of that. How many women are like this? I'm not going by myself.
Thank you. You know what I call us? You're something we use every day, and athletics is called spotting.
I'm going to throw a black ball at him. You think I'm in there? I throw the guy a black ball. Well, so we go, well, he get out of the car. She went on the car like this. Chasing the guy around the car. My wife was chasing me around the car. And she stopped the whole thing by going like this. And I said, well, hey, hon, you want to hit that guy in front of you, children? And I got back in the car. She was right. I said, then what did you say? Because I don't want my husband to arrest him. Why would we be stupid to get out of the car like that? I said, competition. That's the thing that sits on your shoulder. And I lost control of the shoulder. And after one split second, it shouldn't happen, but I had a splatter. She got out of the car and go like that. So what? I got shot. For the first watch, we're kicking his ass. Now, at this part, Congress, I saw our manager get that and goes, we're going to show you something we worked on. We worked on that in practice out. Watch this. The three managers sitting on the bench. The pitcher's out there, we got somebody in bat. And they intentionally throw the ball at the bat. And the batter goes down. By the time he hits the ground and starts to come up, all three coaches run over and they grab him and they put one person between the pitcher and the batter, one person behind, and one on the other side. They call that spotting positions. And when they're walking all the way to first base, he can walk anywhere by himself. They're going like this. Don't even think about it. We know you're pissed. You want to go out there and kick that guy's ass, it's not going to happen. You know what? We need you on your ground. We need you on your team. We can't afford you being thrown out. And they walk all the way down the line with them that way. They work on that for half an hour. And then 1 month later, we're watching the game. We have a great, great outfit on the name of the coach. I'm in front of the name of the coach. He gets hit with a fastball for 100 miles an hour. And you know he's pissed. And all three coaches were out there walking all the way down to first base. And you can see him in a room with the crowd fighting the innings. The coaches did a great job by spotting. And the umpires were out on the pitch, which he should have done. You know, in the playoffs last week, the Pirates ran out, there was going to be a brawl that was going to happen. And all those coaches ran out there and separated everybody. You know what? They know what spotting means, and the coach goes like this. If you can only get that point across, when they go out training and someone's running, then a spotter goes like this. Give me the keys. I'll drive the plane. You're not going to drive home. If they see somebody trying to force alcohol on a young lady, they grab and say, what's wrong with you? That's not going to happen. We represent a family and team. You're not going to hurt somebody. They stand up and they do the right thing. When you see somebody on your team getting out of control, and you see them doing something they shouldn't be doing because they're drunk, you know, be a leader, go over and say something. Walk them home. Do the right thing. Because you know what? Maybe that life that night will stop something before it even starts. Because I really believe that's one big mistake in athletics. We don't teach spot. We don't teach people to be responsible. So you know what? Your coaches, you'll hear that from them now and then after a game. Hey, you know what? Spot time. I know you have what Halloween coming. Don't you have one of the biggest nails right next to you that celebrates Halloween? A lot of them went down, but make sure you have a spot if you're going there. Also, I give a piece of advice for non-drinkers. How many people don't drink at all? Do not drink at all. Drink it up. Put in non-drinkers. All right? Take your own non-alcoholic beverage with you. Take your own bottle. Don't stand there naked. Have a good time. And once that story began, three young ladies died of cocaine. Because they came into the campus to visit. And they went downtown and they weren't drinking. And they made one mistake. They got into a car with somebody that was drunk. And they drove the guys and these ladies back to the campus. And the young man in the tree about 100 miles an hour. And to this day, there's four headstones in front of that tree. Coach is a net record, Colgate. Yeah. And the athletic record guy says, take your ride with me. Hopped up to take that phone call to call their parents and tell them they lost someone because they weren't even drinking. They were riding someone. This brings me to the last point. How many got hurt because of my drinking? How many fall upstairs? How many fall downstairs? How many got bumps and bruises? How many got a UTI? How many UTI has? The guy with a great big mandate on his head. What happened? It's called a UTI, which means what? Unidentified coronary injury. Get up the next day, you have a bump or bruise
reason you became an alcoholic is because you had alcoholic parents. Not true. I wouldn't blame my parents for my problem if one stopped here. I blame this college. It's too easy. If you get drunk every Thursday for a full year, you got drunk 52 times. You get drunk Thursday and Friday, that's 104 days. That's a third of the time. You do Thursday, Friday, and Saturday, you're 156. If you open up to a coach, I want to get stronger, what should I do? They lift weights 3 days a week, Monday, Wednesday, Friday, follow the program. If you never miss, I guarantee you'll get stronger because you're with the time. How many agree with the time to never get stronger? But I'm really an alcoholic problem, we're recovering alcoholic. Hey, when you're in college, that was for this season. When did you get drunk? Thursday and Saturday nights. Out of season. Thursday, Friday, Saturdays, and Mondays. And when I graduated, I started getting drunk about 300 times a year. You know, actually, I think I'd go like this. Out in Tennessee on the football team, give you the survey of a coach, you can have these practices, I don't drink. Well, no, see, when you fire me, you're worse than anybody. I drink beer. Beer's not alcohol, is it? What do you think it is? You go to found my friends say beer is just beer. It is. There's one shot in it. You drink a lot of beer, you drink a lot of alcohol. He goes, Coach, and I got something to come to find first. I don't want to be an alcoholic like him. He goes, I'm the last one to know because I never counted like that. I was always just taking it for granted. Will you talk to me? He goes, absolutely. I come back when you let him run for 300. Down to 90, that's a big change. An extra from 90 down less than 40. Now let's have people from the pros looking at it. They're taking it to the combine. Now they want to be drafted. When you graduate 1 year, you got to start 4 times, you got drafted, and you leave all of them at least once a year and it goes like this. They agree. I still have a piece of paper. You know what? I look at myself once a year. I don't get drunk more than 4 times. I have a family. I care about them more than anything. Get that piece of paper to everybody in the audience. Because if they can look, they can change. The Philadelphia Eagles should get a piece of paper. They're probably used to quite a bit right about that. At this point here, we want people to slow down and be able to look. I got lots of ideas. How many have a good time for the last hour of training? How many have a good time? How many actually learned something? I would appreciate the living style of being straightforward. And 30 years from now, the young children. They go to college. Are you sure you're going to do the same program? I'll be retired. You guys can do the